What's up, Out Labor Great? This is Jason, your Tuesday, and I'm in the living room doing this topic for this week. I'm going to do this really quick. Just got home from work, ate a little dinner, a little tired, so I might go to bed a little earlier tonight. So topic comes from Maya. She picked a topic suggestion from someone, and she's asking, the person's asking, I'm 38 years old, and I've recently come out 4 months ago. It was traumatic, but I made it. I did not have any sex or same-sex encounters or relationships before coming out. Now I've met the great person who I'm interested in, and they're interested in me. We've not taken it any further. What do you think about getting into a relationship with the first person you're interested in after coming out? Do you think this is a bad idea when you're only starting to find your feet in LGBT land? I'm worrying that it's foolish. When I came out after high school, I came out officially to everybody, and I did land a relationship immediately, and it lasted for about a year. But I don't think, for me personally, I don't know if you're ready at that point to make a commitment or to settle down. Some people are, and some people are ready for it, so they'll be ready at that time. But for me at that time, I don't think, now that looking back on it, I don't think I was ready. And that was due to the fact that there was so many people that I had to encounter to become the person I am today. And I've met so many great people, great exes, now that I call exes, along the way. I am still friends with a lot of them. And to me, it is one of those things where I had to meet those people to know that I am ready for a relationship. I'm truly ready for the love of my life to come in and sweep me off my feet. And do I think it's a bad idea? To a certain extent, it may be, but to each his own. Everybody has their own life to lead, to live, and I'm not going to say that it's a bad idea, but you still have a lot to learn. So if a person is that comes into your life and they're ready to make that commitment to you, and they're ready to help you along this journey, and so why the hell not, right? But I think you have a lot to learn, and they need to be ready and prepared to answer those questions, especially if they have history in terms of living an out and fulfilled life. You probably may not have that type of experience yet, and you may come into contact of jealousy, anger. And I want you to stop, think about the situation, and not, to me, I think you're going to be a little bit more jealous of a person that that's in your life that has that experience. And probably they've gone through those experiences, and they're advising you of the same exact thing. So a lot of times, people who has a lot of experience like myself, I tend to be like, you know, please don't do that. But to me, I think, okay, I want you to stop and, you know, think about it first, you know. But hi, baby. My husband's going in the kitchen. Just about a week ago, we got married, people. And he's in the kitchen. What are you looking for? A fruit cup?
No.
Oh. So, yeah, a person might have a lot of experience in the gay community, so you're going to have the feeling of jealousy sometimes, and the feeling of, okay, why are you not letting me do this and learn, you know? So, hopefully I'm making sense. I don't know if I'm making sense. I'm a little distracted tonight, but I don't know if it's a bad idea. I can't say it's a bad idea, but I can say that it's going to be a learning experience, and whoever you're with is going to need to deal with it. to say you have to deal with it. Hi, my baby. You want to say hi to everybody? Say hi to... No, come say hi. Come, the babe. Babe. Come here. I guess he's not coming back. He's not coming back. He went into the room. Anyways, I will catch you guys all later. I love you. And you guys see all the peach fuzz under my armpit. I love you guys. Bye.